Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Join fast for the session. Yes, it's sharp 10:30. We are about to begin the mega marathon on the very first unit for class 11th NCRT. All of you join the session fast. Hello, Nantita Nila. Welcome to BioPoint for Needs. We'll be starting. All the other person have the Josh in the class. Yes, Vineet. Yes, Dima. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Aren't you all excited for the class on the mega marathon? Okay, without wasting our time, we are moving on with a super cool class. Okay, we are launching the Mega Marathon 2020 Crash Course for NEET from your favorite BioPoint, Stream the World of Bio. Yes. Good morning, everybody. Guru, Jeswin, Hari Shankar, everybody, good morning. Okay, guys, can you hear my voice clearly now? Please come in fast in the chat box. Okay. So this is the last minute revision LMR from BioPoint for NEET Maha Marathon, Unit 1, Diversity in the Living World. So without wasting our time, we are moving on to the last minute revision from the chapter Living World. If you have any doubt regarding these chapters, you have to complete the theory of all these four chapters today within this 2-hour class. Clear, everybody? Okay. Don't forget to click the like button now itself. And let's begin the class. All important points are included on the slide today. So, those who need the important points can take it down in your notebook or your NCERT textbook. All have to keep your NCERT textbook beside you. So, starting the class from the chapter Life Processes, Characteristics of Life. What are the most important characteristics of life or living beings? It is highly organized. It is cellular structure. Consciousness. Consciousness is one of the most important factor that determines whether an organism is living or non-living. Then growth and development, reproduction and heredity, metabolism and energy requirement. These are the characteristics of life or living organism. This is a previous year NEET question. Okay, take it down in your textbook. This is one of the previous year NEET question. Page number 4 and 5 from your NCERT textbook. Those who have your NCERT textbook by your side, take down that. Okay, previous year NEET question. The question was, which of the following are not a defining character of a living being? So you have to study these all options as per your NCERT textbook and write down the answer. What are the main characteristics? They are highly organized, cellular structure. Consciousness is a defining property whether a living organism, an organism is considered to be living or not. Guys, can you all hear my voice? The chat box is remaining silent. Why? Okay, be energetic, guys, on the chat box. Next is, what are the characteristic features of living organism? So you have 4 features from your NCERT, that is growth, reproduction, metabolism and response to stimuli. Okay, so these are the 4 main characteristics of living organisms, that is growth, reproduction, metabolism and response to stimulus. Next is the diversity in the living world. Biodiversity. You have a chapter biodiversity from your class 12th, last and the final chapter, right? So this is also a previous year NEET MCQ. How many organisms are there existed on the earth? It is 1.7 to 1.8 million. Please bookmark this particular point. It is there in your NCERT page number 6. First paragraph. Are you all having an NCERT in your hand? Do you all have your NCERT in your hand now? Class 11th NCERT, fast on the chat box. Okay, please take down all these important points over there. Okay. So there are how many organisms? 1.7 to 1.8 million organisms. Next process is the identification. Identification is a comparing the similarities and differences. Okay. Comparing the similarities and differences of the already known organism. Next term is the nomenclature. What do you mean by nomenclature? The names are unique and universal. It is a process of naming of an organism. We have a common name for a particular organism. We have a common name for a particular organism, but that name may vary from one place to another. In order to ensure a continuity or a universality, we are just putting the term nomenclature. And who proposed the binomial nomenclature? Important question for your NEET. Binomial nomenclature was proposed by Carl Linnaeus. Carl Linnaeus. Okay, guys, please take note of this particular spelling of this particular biologist. It is written as Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, one time this was a previous year NEET question, and the options was all the father of binomial nomenclature. Option one, it was given like Carl Linnaeus. Option two, it was Carl Linnaeus. The spelling was like this. Okay, Carl Linnaeus. Carl Linnaeus. And the third option was Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, so whenever you study, just have a look at the spelling of that particular thing also. Okay, otherwise you will get a doubt when these kinds of questions come for your exam. Clear everybody with this wonderful idea? A previous year NEET MCQ. When you tell, you will be telling it as a Carl Linnaeus, but when you write it, it is Carolus Linnaeus. So option three is the answer. Okay, next is the rules for nomenclature. The rules for nomenclature are provided by ICBN and ICZN. ICBN and ICZN. This is also a previous year NEET MCQ. This is also a previous year NEET MCQ. Guru, are you here? Dr. Deema Divakaran, Pranav, Vinit, Jeswin, everybody is here. Are you all here? Okay. ICBN stands for the International Court for Botanical Nomenclature. International Court for Botanical Nomenclature. And ICZN stands for International Court of Zoological Nomenclature. This is very, very important previous year NEET question. You can expect a question for NEET 2020 also from this particular term. Nomenclature for plants is done by ICBN, International Court for Botanical Nomenclature. It is International Court and it is not Indian Court. Okay, the option will contain Indian Court for Botanical Nomenclature also. When you guys see botanical nomenclature, you will click that answer. You will write that answer or bubble that answer. But you have to check whether it is given International or Indian Court of Botanical Nomenclature. Okay, we are moving on with the next one. This is very important. So moving on with the next. Binomial nomenclature. Concept of binomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature was given by Carl Linnaeus. Carl Linnaeus is also known as the father of taxonomy. Look at the spelling. It is Carolus Linnaeus. When you pronounce, you will be telling it as the Carl Linnaeus. Guys, please don't make the chat box remain silent like this. Okay, when the chat box is remaining silent, I think you people are not listening in the class. Whenever you are clear with some idea, particular idea, you can comment something in the chat box. Okay, this is also a previous year. So one NEET MCQ from the very first sentence itself, father of taxonomy, Carl Linnaeus. This is another NEET MCQ, previous year NEET MCQ. That is, binomial nomenclature consists of generic name and a specific epithet. Guys, please take care of this particular thing, that is specific epithet. Because when you write, you have the genus or the generic name comes in the first of a binomial nomenclature, and you guys will write the second is followed by the specific name or species name. It is specific epithet. In your option, you can expect what species name or specific name. Specific epithet or option D, generic name. guys, if I'm asking you a question, in case of the scientific name that is Mangifera, indica, what does this term indica refers to? Option A, specific epithet. Option B, specific name. Option C, species name. And option D, generic name. Yes, you guys must note this particular thing. In Mangifera indica, the term indica refers to specific epithet. It is not species name, it is specific epithet. Everybody clear? Everybody clear with the idea? Yes. This is guidelines for nomenclature is another neat MCQ. At least 10 times repeated previous year question. At least 10 times previous year question. Guidelines and principles for nomenclature. It should be written in Latin or they must be derived from Latin. They must be written in italics when typed and underlined when handwritten. Guys, you know all these points. If you have any doubt, don't feel shy to ask in the chat box. I will reply to your comment. The generic name or the genus name always starts with a capital letter, while as a specific epithet, it starts with a small letter. Okay, the name should be short, precise, and easy to pronounce. And the name of the author is written in the abbreviated form at the end of the biological name. For example, Mangifera indica Linn. Linn stands for Linnaeus. Clear, everybody? You have to study. You have to have an idea about all these rules as well as about the scientific names also. Clear? They will be giving you 4 or 5 scientific name and will be asking you to write which one is the correctly written scientific name according to the basic principles of nomenclature. Okay? For examples, Mangifera indica, Manco, Homo sapiens, human, Panthera pardus, it is leopard, and Felis domestica, it is the cat. Clear? Okay, we are moving on with the next one. Classification. Classification refers to grouping of organisms into category based on the observable character. Observable characters, okay? Taxonomy refers to characterization, identification, classification, and nomenclature are the process of taxonomy. This is a previous year NEET MCQ. Identify the very first step in the process of taxonomy. That was a previous year question, but the option doesn't contain the term characterization. Okay, it doesn't contain the term characterization, and the first option was identification. So, identification was the answer for that question during that year NEET examination. Clear? This is a very frequently asked question. What are the steps involved in taxonomy? It is there in the page number 7 of your class 11 in the NCRT. Page number 7 of class 11 NCRT. Next is systematics. Systematics is the different kinds of organisms and the relationship. The relation between different organisms is known as systematics. The word systematics is derived from the Latin word system, which means arrangement of organisms in a systematic way. Linnaeus used Systema Naturae for his publication. Very, very important. Another neat MCQ. Very, very important. Another neat MCQ. At least 5 times a repeated question for neat. Linnaeus used Systema Naturae. Name the book in which Linnaeus published his theories related to systematics. The answer is Systema Naturae. Next is taxonomic hierarchy. It is based on the similarities and differences. Okay, as we go from species to kingdom, as we go from species to kingdom, the number of common character decreases. Very, very important neat question, at least 20 times a repeated question for your entrance exam. Okay, very, very important. As we go from species to kingdom, the number of common character goes on decreasing. Guys, if anybody is getting at least one extra point from the a particular slide, please somebody take a screenshot of that particular slide and post it in the group now itself, in our Telegram group. Clear? So I am arranging it from the higher to lower, that is K, P, C of GS. KPC of GS. Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. Group of related species forms the genus. Group of related genus forms the family. Genus together form the order. Order forms the class. Class forms the phylum. Phylum ultimately forms the kingdom. Can anybody tell me what is the term that we use for phylum? What is the other term that you use for phylum in case of plants? We study phylum in the animal kingdom. What do you will use for the other term for phylum in case of plants? Exactly, Anuradha, it is division. Yes, everybody is telling. Deema, Jasmine, everybody telling. So phylum is replaced by division, the term division in case of plants. Clear? So next one, so this also you have to make a note of this particular thing. Okay, species, kingdom, family, order, class, phylum or division, and kingdom. This is also a repeated neat MCQ. Every time they may be asking you which of the following is correctly arranged in the order of taxonomy category. This is a table which is directly taken from your NCERT textbook. Okay, NCERT textbook, page number 11. Okay, page number 11, you have this table. Organisms with their taxonomic category. Among this, human being and housefly is a commonly asked question for NEET. Okay, commonly asked question among the following is, human being and housefly is a regular repeated trend that you can see in your NEET examination. That is, Homo sapiens, you can see their biological name. The biological name for man is Homo sapiens. What does the term Homo stands for? Guys, tell me, what does Homo stands for in the term Homo sapiens? Fast on the chat box. What does the term Homo stands for? Yes, it is generic name, or it stands for the genus. Guys, have you all liked the session? Have you all liked the session? Okay, Homo. Hominidae stands for family. A group of related genus is termed as family, and that is hominidae. Next you have primata, which is the order. Then chordata and mammalia. Study all these things. Homo is the genus, followed by hominidae is the family. Hominidae is the family. But in case of plants, you can see, you can easily identify the name of the family, because the name of the family ends with C-E-A-E. Okay, it ends with this particular statement or this particular letters in case of plants. But if you look it over here, you can see in case of animals, it ends with the letter D-A-E. hominidae, musidae. Okay, in case of house fly, the scientific name is Musa domestica. Musca stands for the genus name. Musidae stands for the family. This is a repeated question. Many of you will get confused whether Diptera is family or order. Diptera is order. Okay, class Insecta and phylum Arthropoda. Mango, Mangifera indica. Mangifera is the genus name. Anacardaceae is the family. Sapindales is the order. Dicotyledonae is the class. And Angiospermae is the division. Wheat, Triticum aestivum. That is, Triticum is the genus. Poaceae is the family. Poales is the order. Monocotyledonae is the class. And Angiosperma is the division. Hope everybody understood. Please bookmark the table and refer the table on page number 11 in your class 11 NCRT. Next, moving on to the last portion of the chapter, very important portion of this particular chapter, that is all about taxonomical aids. These are the procedures and techniques used to store, and preserve information as well as specimens of various plants and animals, not only about any one thing, that is plants. We are using taxonomical aids for classifying or identifying organisms in both plants and animals. They help in the identification, naming and classification of organism. Very important. So this is also a repeated NEET MCQ. Herbarium is a storehouse of plant specimen. Herbarium can also be referred to as the dry garden. Herbarium can also be referred to as the dry garden because all the plant specimens are dried, pressed, and then stored inside the herbarium. Collected plant specimens are dried, pressed, and preserved on sheets. And then they are arranged systematically according to the universally accepted system of classification. This is 2016 NEET previous year MCQ. You can see when you have any guide with you, you can refer 2016 NEET MCQ. Such a simple question. Herbarium sheet contains which of the following? The question was, which of the following is not found in a herbarium sheet? The answer was the height of the plant. You have all other option. Label regarding the date of collection, the place of collection, the scientific name of that particular thing or the plant, family, collector's name, etc. You don't have a information about the height of the plant on an herbarium sheet. This is also a previous year AIIMS question, a repeated AIIMS question. Okay. Herbarium sheet size, the size of a herbarium sheet, 29 into 41.5 centimeter or 11.5 into 16.5 inches. Everybody in the class enjoying the session on the mega marathon number one. Okay, next is the botanical garden. Botanical garden refers to the collection of living plant species that are grown for identification and reference. So in the botanical garden, you have the living plant species. Okay, living plant species is found in the botanical garden. Yes, Gopi, welcome to the class. Each plant contains labels indicating their scientific name and family. Okay, all the plants in the botanical garden contains the scientific name and family. Indian botanical garden, for example, some of the names of the botanical garden is Indian botanical garden in Howrah, Royal botanical garden Kew in England, and the National botanical garden Lucknow in India. Indian Botanical Garden is located in Kolkata. Have you anybody visited a botanical garden in your state or your nearby places? Have you anybody visited? Next is the museum. So this is okay. How was it? How was the children who have visited the botanical garden? Is it very interesting to see different species of plants growing in a particular area? Yes. So this, the names of the botanical garden is very important. And about the botanical garden, you can see in page number 12 of your class 11th NCERT textbook. Okay. Museum is a repository, very important term, repository, that have a collection of various plants and animal specimens that are preserved for study and reference. The organisms are preserved either in a preservative solution, and that preservative solution you can call it as a formalin. And it also has a collection of skeletons of animals. For example, in case of certain birds and animals, the birds and animals, they are stuffed with the plaster of Paris or cotton. They are stuffed with the plaster of Paris or cotton in order to get their outer structures, in order to study their outer structures clearly. Okay. Next, we have zoological parks. Zoological park is the area where wild animals are kept in protected environment under human care. Okay. Where wild animals are kept in protected environment under human care. Okay, clear with this particular idea of the taxonomical aids. About the zoological garden, you have in your page number 13. So next one, most probably this would be the last slide of the chapter, Living World. It provides an opportunity for studying the behavior. It provides an opportunity, okay, the zoological parks. Most of you have been to a zoo, a zoological park, zoo, okay. Most of you might have visited the zoological park or the zoo for studying the behavior and the food habits of different animals, okay. Then last one is the key, very, very important concept from this chapter, key. Keys are used for the identification of plants and animals. They are based on certain similarities and dissimilarities. They are based on certain similarities and dissimilarities, and they are analytical in nature. Analytical in nature. Guys, is there anybody who is not in a Telegram group? Is there anybody in the class who is not in a Telegram group? Okay, guys, tell me in the chat box, what do you call the keys are based? I told you the keys are based on certain contrasting character. That is, the keys are based on similarities and dissimilarities. What term would you give to such contrasting characters which generally occur in a pair? What do you call the contrasting character? Fast on the chat box, anybody thorough with this chapter? Yes. Yes, Deema Divakaran, it is couplet. It is not lead, it is couplet. It is couplet. Okay. And each statement in the key, each statement in the key that helps us to move forward, you can call it as the lead. Okay. You can call it as to be the lead. Then other taxonomic things or other taxonomic aids are manuals, monographs, catalogs are other means of recording the description. Manuals helps in the identification of names of various species of organisms in a given area. Manuals helps in the identification of names of various species of organisms in a particular area. Monograph is a detailed and well-documented work on any one particular taxon. Everybody have to bookmark this particular point, on any one particular taxon. On any one particular taxon. Clear, everyone? Everybody? Tell me whether wheat is a monocot or a dicot plant. Tell me whether wheat is a monocot or a dicot plant. Yes, Divahar, it is a monocot plant. It is a monocot plant. Can you tell me the type of pollination or the pollinating agent in wheat? Or what type of pollination, whether it is entomophily, anemophily, hydrophily? What is the type of pollination that you can see in wheat? Yes, Harishanga, it is wind. And what do you call the term for the pollination by wind? Divagar, is it entomophily? Is it entomophily? Yeah, guys, it is wind pollination. And what do you call that term? Yes, Divagar, it is anemophily. It is anemophily. Guys, who proposed the two kingdom system of classification? Who proposed the two kingdom system of classification? Fast answer on the chat box. Two kingdom system of classification. It's Guru, it's not Aristotle, it is Linnaeus. Linnaeus proposed the two kingdom system of classification. Okay, Carl Linnaeus proposed the two kingdom system of classification. Who proposed the three kingdom system of classification? Who proposed the three kingdom system of classification? Those who don't know the answer, please write it in your NCRT now itself. This is a last minute revision. Yes, Harishanka, it is E.H. Haeckel. Haeckel proposed the three kingdom system of classification. Guys, clear up to here? Each and every point that I have taught in the class, is it clear for everybody? Everybody? Okay. So most probably I think that chapter is over and we are moving on with the LMR or the last minute revision on mega marathon from the chapter biological classification. Ready for the session? Super amazing session on biological classification. Okay, let's start the session. Okay. Okay, all your eyes on the screen. Starting the chapter biological classification. Aristotle was the earliest to attempt a more scientific basis of classification, but he used simple morphological characters to classify plants. Okay, he used simple morphological characters to classify plants, and he classified plants into trees, shrubs, and herbs. Okay, and he divided the animals into two groups based upon the type of color of blood. The animals that having red blood and the animals that did not have a red blood. He divided the organisms like that. Yeah, exactly, Divahar. Red blood as anemia, and those that did not have red blood as anemia. Okay, those organisms that have a red blood, he classified them as anemic organisms, and those that did not have, he classified them as the anemic organism. Okay, so next one, this concept is clear, I suppose, for everyone. So biological classification. Guys, do not have your NCERT textbook? Or else all have your NCERT textbook with you? Anybody doesn't have NCERT textbook? Okay. Nila, what happened? Do you have NCERT or not? Guys, almost all the points in the NCERT, I have included it in the slides. And those who need it, watch it again on the YouTube, and or else you can take a screenshot and save it in your mobile. Okay. Or else if you want your NCERT, you can download it from the net also. For biology, nearly. Oh, you don't have your NCERT textbook. Don't worry. If you need, you can download it as PDF from the internet. NCERT. You have to search ncert.nic.in. From there, you can download the PDF of the entire book, or entire chapter wise also you can have it. Or else just take a screenshot of all these things. For NEET examination, 60% of the questions comes from your class 11 biology. Okay. And the rest 40% only comes from your class 12. And among that 40% from class 12, majority marks for the chapter heredity, evolution, molecular basis of inheritance and evolution. And from class 11, most important chapter, human physiology. Okay. In a earlier system of classification, it included bacteria, blue-green algae, fungi, mosses, ferns, gymnosperms, and angiosperm under the class plant. So now bacteria is classified under Monera. Blue-green algae under Monera. Fungi is a separate kingdom. Mosses, ferns, gymnosperms, angiosperms are all under plants. So, in the earlier classification, anatomy, morphology, and structural organization, only few questions. nearly 3 questions from all the chapters. Okay, most probably 3 questions from all the chapter, and the question from the 2 chapters, that is structural organization and anatomy of flowering plants, will be directly from your NCERT. But the question from the chapter morphology will be a really tricky question. They will come about the yeast evasion or phyllotaxy. They will asking a tricky question only based on the example. Those who by heart the examples from that chapter will really score good marks for that particular unit. Okay, so in the earlier classification, it was based on classifying the organism based on the presence or absence of cell wall. It brought together, what were the disadvantages? It brought together all the prokaryotic bacteria and blue-green algae with other groups which were eukaryote. Guys, what is a eukaryote or a prokaryotic organism? What is a prokaryotic organism? Tell me in the chat box. Prokaryotic organism. Yeah, their nuclear membrane is absent. Okay, so eukaryotic are those organisms that is having a nuclear membrane and membrane bound organelles, whereas prokaryote, they do not have membrane bound organelles. It also grouped together the unicellular organisms and the multicellular organisms together. For example, Chlamydomonas and Spirogyra were placed together under the class algae. The classification does not differentiate between the heterotrophic group fungi and the autotrophic green plants. Guys, can you name the organism that behave as an autotroph in the presence of light and that behave as a heterotroph in the absence of light? If you know the answer, comment the answer fast, and if you don't know, comment no in the chat box so that I could move faster. That is, that organism is having a mixotrophic. Yes, Dr. Deema Divakaran, it is Euglena. Okay, guys, Euglena is the organism that behaves as photosynthetic in the presence of light, and it behaves as heterotrophic, that is a saprophytic animal, in the absence of light. Okay, next is the five kingdom system of classification. Five kingdom system of classification was proposed by R.H. Whittaker in the year 1969. This year for five kingdom system of classification is 2010 NEET MCQ. And the main criteria for classification used by R.H. Whittaker is cell structure, thallus organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction, and phylogenetic relationship. At least 20 times repeated MCQ, my guaranteed MCQ for NEET 2020. 100% MCQ question. Okay. Page number 17 of your class 11th NCERT, page number 11. Okay, kingdom Protista has brought together Chlamydomonas, Chlorella. Earlier they were placed in algae within the plants, and both having cell walls, with Paramecium and Amoeba, which were earlier placed in the animal kingdom. Guys, in some of your NCERT textbook, Chlamydomonas and Chlorella are placed under algae. That is the earlier method of classification. Okay, in the revised edition of NCRT, in the revised edition of NCRT, they are included under the chapter Protista, or included under Protista Kingdom, Protista. Please take care of that. Okay. So you have to study, name the scientists who proposed the Five Kingdom system of classification, and what were the main criteria that he used for his classification. Two most important MCQs from that particular slide. Next is Kingdom Monera. Bacteria are the sole members of Kingdom Monera, and what are their common character? They are the most abundant microorganism. They have a rigid cell wall. They have a rigid cell wall which is made up of murine or peptidoglycan. Peptidoglycan or murine is only found in the cell wall of organisms belonging to Kingdom Monera. Then histones are absent. DNA is scattered in the cytoplasm. Their ribosome is a 70S ribosome. 70S ribosome you have studied in the chapter Cell, the Basic Unit of Life. It is also called a prokaryotic ribosome. Can anybody tell me what is the type of ribosome found or ribosome found in a eukaryotic organism? Type of ribosome found in the eukaryotic organism. Yes, ATS ribosome, exactly. These Kingdom Monerans belong to extreme habitats such as hot spring, deserts, snow, deep oceans, and where a few other can live in other life forms also. Most of these organisms are parasite. This is an assertion reasoning question. Okay, most of them can live as parasite. And most of you may keep the food, the preserved food. In order to preserve the food, we keep it in the refrigerator. There are some organisms that can thrive or survive well in the cold habit, even in minus 100 degrees Celsius. Also, they can survive very greatly. So, refrigeration doesn't kill all the bacteria, or boiling also doesn't kill all the bacteria. This is a previous year, at least 10 times repeated MCQ for your needs. Bacteria are classified under four categories based on their shape. Okay, the spiracle bacteria is called the coccus. The rod-shaped bacteria called the bacillus. Coma-shaped bacteria, vibrium. And spiral-shaped, spirillum. Okay. Coccus, bacillus, spirillum, and vibrium. Clear with these four types of bacteria? They are very complex in nature. They are very complex in behavior also. Okay. The most extensive metabolic diversity is obtained. This is also a previous year NEET question. Okay. Name the type, name the organism belonging to the kingdom that have the maximum metabolic diversity. It is Kingdom Monera. Okay. Next, we have told. Guys, tell me what is the substance that make up the cell wall of Kingdom Monera? The cell wall material of Kingdom Monera. Fast on the chat box. Fast. Peptidoglycan or murine. Peptidoglycan or murine. We have discussed in the last slide, right? Peptidoglycan or murine. Guys, tell me, this peptidoglycan is composed of two sub units. Can anybody tell me What are the subunits or peptidoglycan is composed of? Yeah, tell me fast, Pranav. If you know the answer, tell me fast. What are the units of peptidoglycan or murine? Yes, it is NAG and NAM. NAG and NAM. What is NAG? NAG is N-acetyl. N-acetyl glucosamine. N-acetyl glucosamine. And NAM is N-acetyl muramic acid. Nila, you are not responding. What happened? Are you getting all the points? Jasmine, are you here? Okay. Some bacteria synthesize their own food from inorganic substrate. Okay. Certain bacteria that synthesize their own food from inorganic substrates. Next, we are going to study the concept of archaea bacteria. They live in the most harsh habitat. Most harsh habits. This is also a repeated neat question. Name the group of monerans that can live in the most harsh condition. That is archaea bacteria. For example, extreme salinity. You call it as halophiles. They are anaerobe. Okay. No, it is not eubacteria. It is archaea bacteria. Okay. Those organisms living in the most harsh condition, it is archaea bacteria. For example, those living in the saline environment, they are anaerobe and you can call it as to be the halophiles. Those living in hot spring, you can call it as to be thermoacidophiles. Thermoacidophiles, aerobic in nature. Those living in marshy areas, you can call it as the methanogens. They are anaerobic in nature. Guys, getting the points, everyone? Yes, archaea bacteria is a primitive bacteria. And the cell wall of archaea bacteria is made up of pseudomurine. Archaea bacteria. This is 2015 AIIMS question. Archaea bacteria differ from all other bacteria in having a different cell wall structure. They have a branched chain lipids, and this feature is responsible for their survival in the extreme harsh condition. Somebody can take a screenshot of this slide and post it in the group. Okay, this is not in your NCRT. Archaea bacteria differs from other kinds of bacteria in their cell wall structure. That is, their cell wall structure is a branched chain lipids, and this feature is responsible for their survival in the extreme condition. Next is methanogens. You may be common with the term methanogens. They are present in the gut of ruminant animal. Ruminant animal means cud chewing animal. For example, cow, goat, etc. Those eat the grass. That is cud chewing animal or ruminant animal. Such as cows and buffaloes, and they are responsible for the production of methane biogas from the dung of these animals. There are millions and millions of methanogens present in the cow dung. Clear with this idea? Next is eubacteria. After we finish Monera, I'll tell the extra points related to Kingdom Monera. They are characterized by the presence of a rigid cell wall. that is made up of polysaccharide and amino acid. Okay, eubacteria is characterized by the presence of a rigid cell wall that is made up of polysaccharide and amino acid. And if they are motile, that may be with the help of a flagellum. Cyanobacteria commonly referred to as the blue-green algae or Myxobacteria, very important. Or BG also you can, BGA, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria, blue-green algae. Myxobacterium, they have, this is the most important character, they have chlorophyll A, which is similar to the pigment present in green plants, and they are photosynthetic autotrophs. Okay, their colonies are generally surrounded by a gelatinous sheath. They often form algal blooms in polluted water, and some of them can fix atmospheric nitrogen with the help of specialized nitrogen fixing cells called a heterocyst. For example, Nostoc, Anabena, Oscillataria, etc. This is in your page number 19 of biological classification. Can anybody tell me the name of the nitrogen fixing enzyme that is present in the heterocyst? Anybody tell me the name of the enzyme that helps to fix the nitrogen in the heterocyst, which is a specialized cell? Fast. If you know, comment the answer, or if you don't know, comment no. I will tell the answer. Fast, we have two more chapters to finish. That's an example. Nostoc and Anabena are the examples of organism that containing heterocyst. I'm asking about the enzyme. The enzyme is nitrogenase. Okay. Nitrogenase is the enzyme that helps to fix nitrogen in specialized cells called heterocyst. Take down those who don't have the answer. Take down, nitrogenase is the enzyme. Okay. Chemosynthetic autotrophs. They obtain their food by oxidation. This is a previous year AIPMT question. Name the group of bacteria or name the group of monerans that helps to or that play a great role in recycling nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, and sulfur. That is chemosynthetic autotrophs. They play a very important role in the recycling of nutrients. Okay. Next, we have the heterotrophic bacteria. Heterotrophic bacteria are the most abundant in nature. Heterotrophic bacteria is the most abundant bacteria in nature. The majority are important decomposers. Clear, everybody? Okay. Okay. Guys, can you all hear me? Okay, we are moving on with the next one. Bacteria reproduces mainly by fission, binary fission or multiple fission. Sometimes under unfavorable condition, they also produce spore. The term plasmid, it is given by Lederberg, given by the scientist called Lederberg. He given the term plasmid. What do you mean by plasmids? Plasmids are extra chromosomal small circular DNA fragments. Okay, this you will study in the chapter biotechnology about the plasmids. So what are plasmids? Don't get confused when you study the chapter. Plasmids are the extra chromosomal small circular double-stranded DNA molecules. Next is episomes. What are episomes? When plasmids are integrating into bacterial DNA chromosome, they are called as episomes. When plasmids are integrating into or they are getting added into the bacterial DNA chromosome, they are called as episome. Clear, everyone? Next, another important question that comes for your exam is from the mycoplasma. Mycoplasma is known as the jokers of plant kingdom. 100% direct MCQ. 100% MCQ. These organisms completely lack a cell wall. That is the main characteristic of these organisms. They do not have a cell wall and they are the smallest living cells known and they are anaerobic in nature. That is, they do not need oxygen for survival. They are also known as PPLO or pleuropneumonia-like organism. Pleuropneumonia-like organism or PPLO. So all these are the main things that you have to study from the chapter Monera or the kingdom Monera. Next, we are moving on with kingdom Protista. All single-celled eukaryotes are placed under Protista. Out of the five kingdoms that was introduced by Whittaker, only one kingdom, that is kingdom Monera, is having a prokaryotic species. All single-celled eukaryotes are placed under the kingdom Protista. The Protista include chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime molds, and protozoan. Members of Protista are primarily aquatic. Guys, if you have any doubt regarding any one of the topic that I am teaching, you can comment me in the comment section. I will rewind the slide and will explain. Okay? Don't keep quiet if you have any doubt in any topics. Okay, since this is a last minute revision, I'm going a little bit faster because we have two more chapters to finish. The kingdom forms a link with others dealing with plant, animals, and fungi. Being eukaryote, the protistan cell contains a well-defined nucleus. Okay, a well-defined nucleus and other membrane-bound organelles. Eukaryotic organism has membrane bound organelles, ribosome being a membrane less organelle. It is found also in prokaryotic organism. Protist reproduces asexually and sexually by a process involving cell fusion and zygote formation. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss the things about chrysophytes. Okay, chrysophytes. Chrysophytes include diatoms and golden algae or desmids. Diatoms and golden algae or desmids comes under chrysophytes. They are found in fresh water as well as in marine environment. They are microscopic, float passively in water current. That is plankton. This is NEET 2016 question. Which of the following statement is correct about chrysophytes? And one of the options was they are microscopic, float passively in water current. In diatoms, the cell wall forms two thin overlapping shells which fit together like a soap box. The walls are embedded with silica and the walls are indestructible. You cannot destroy the walls of diatom due to the deposition of the silical material. Diatoms are left behind a large amount of cell wall deposits when they die. So as the diatoms die, they left behind a large amount of silica deposits which gets accumulated over billions of years. This is also an important neat question. How many years will it take to form diatomaceous earth? It is billions of years. This is in your NCRT page number 20. page number 20. Being gritty, this soil or the diatomaceous earth is used in polishing, filtration of oil, syrup. You can also use it to build soundproofing material, ceramics, toothpaste, cosmetics, etc. are made from the diatomaceous earth. Diatomaceous earth are the chief producers in the ocean. Very, very important NEET MCQ. Clear with the all the points regarding chrysophytes. Next is dinoflagellates. Dinoflagellates are otherwise known as fire algae. I think this would be a new term for you. Dinoflagellates or fire algae. Okay, this is not in your NCRT. Please take it down on your NCRT. And about dinoflagellates in page number 21. These organisms are mostly marine and photosynthetic in nature. They appear yellow, green, blue, red. Okay. Guys, what is the main important thing that you have studied about dinoflagellates in your class 11th protista? The most important organism, name the organism and the phenomenon that it causes. It is a dinoflagellate. We studied about diatomaceous earth in diatoms. And after that, in dinoflagellates, you will study a phenomenon and an organism that causes that phenomenon. Yes, exactly, Dima. It is red tide. It is a red tide. Red tide is caused by an organism known as Gornilox. Okay, guys, others also know it about red tide and Gornilox. Yes, the cell wall has stiff cellulosic plates on the outer surface. They have two flagella. They have two flagella. One lies longitudinally. The diagram is in your textbook. Okay. They have two flagella. One lies longitudinally and other lies transversely in a furrow between the two wall plates. Okay. One is lying longitudinally and other is transversely between the wall plates. Red dinoflagellates Gornilox, responsible for the sea, appears to be red in color and it causes a condition called red tide. The toxins released by large numbers may kill other marine animals such as fishes. This is a neat MCQ. Okay, this is a MCQ. Guys, can anybody tell me, name the toxin that this Gornilox release that kills the life or that threatens the life of the other existing organism? Anybody, if you don't know, please come and know fast so that I could move forward with the answer. Or else you can just give a try. Okay. So the toxin is saxitoxin. Take down saxitoxin. Okay, saxitoxin is the toxin that is secreted by Gornilox and it is a nerve toxin that affects our nervous system. It is a nerve toxin. Take down in the notebook or your NCRT textbook by the side of dinoflagellates on page number 21. Okay. So they have two flagella, one longitudinally and other transversely. Next is Euglenoids, as you already told, that they are mixotrophic in nature. They have a mixotrophic mode of nutrition. Majority of them are freshwater organisms found in stagnant water. Instead of a cell wall, they have a protein-rich layer called a pellicle, which makes their body flexible. This is an important MCQ. They have two flagella, one short and one long. So if a flagella is one short and one long, that condition you call it as the heterocond condition. Heterocond. They are photosynthetic in the presence of light, and when they are deprived of sunlight, they behave like heterotrophs by predating on other smaller organisms. They behave as predators. The pigments of euglenoids are identical to those present in higher plants, and the example of euglenoid is Euglena. Almost covered all the points that are mentioned in your NCRT. They have a pellicle rich layer that makes their body flexible. They have two flagella, that is, you call it as to be the heterocond. They are mixotropic in nature. They have a mixotropic nutrition, that is, in the presence of light, they behave as photosynthetic. And when they are deprived of light, they behave as heterotrophic organism by predating on smaller organism. The pigments of euglenoids are identical to those present in higher plants, for example, Euglena. Okay, next one. Guys, do you feel this session is useful? Please comment fast in the chat box. Do you feel this session is extremely useful? A last minute revision. Is it extremely a last minute revision for everybody? Next is slime molds or slime fungi. Slime molds are saprophytic protists. This is an MCQ. Okay. The body moves along decaying twigs and leaf, engulfing organic material. Under suitable condition, this is a previous year question. Under suitable condition, they form aggregation called a plasmodium, which may grow and spread over several feet. And what does happen to them in unfavorable condition? The plasmodium differentiates and forms fruiting bodies that bear spores at their tip. These two statements are very important. They are extremely resistant and survive for many years under adverse condition, because during the unfavorable condition, they form aggregates, that is fruiting bodies bearing spores at the tip, and during favorable condition, they form plasmodium. The spores are dispersed by air current. Okay, these spores are dispersed by air current. Okay, Madhu, Madhurima, are you understanding all these things? For example, Physarum and Physarilla, they are examples of slime mold. Almost all the points from NCRT has been covered. Next is protozoan, animal-like protist. All protozoans are heterotrophic and live as predators or parasites. They are believed to be primitive relators of animal. Very, very important. There are four major group of protozoan. The first one is amoeboid protozoan. They move and capture their food with the help of false feet or pseudopodia, as in amoeba, and amoeba is a freshwater organism. Marine organisms have a silica shell. Some of them are endoparasite. For example, endamoeba histolytica act as an endoparasite. Contractile vacuoles are present in amoeba. That is, they are present in endamoeba, but it is absent in amoeba. Very important point. Guys, anybody, can you tell me the function of this contractile vacuole? For what? What is the function that is served by the contractile vacuole? I'll give you the option. Option 1, circulation. Option 2, excretion. Option 3, digestion. And option D, osmoregulation. Anybody fast on the chat box? Okay, one is telling excretion. What about the answer for this? Everybody going with the answer excretion? guys, the answer is osmoregulation. Okay, the answer is osmoregulation. Amoeboid protozoans. Amoeboid protozoan helps in, that is, in amoeboid protozoan, contractile vacuoles helps in osmoregulation. It is not excretion, it is not circulation or digestion. It helps in osmoregulation. Take down all these things if you don't know. Flagellated protozoan, they are either free living or parasitic. They have flagella. That why is the name flagellated protozoan. Trypanosoma gambiensis. Trypanosoma gambiensis is the example for flagellated protozoan. Flagellated protozoan is the most dangerous group of protozoan that causes a disease called sleeping sickness. That causes a disease called sleeping sickness, and this was observed first in Africa. Sleeping sickness in Africa. And can anybody tell me the vector or the organism that carry trypanosoma from person to person that causes the disease sleeping sickness? Can anybody tell me the vector or the organism that transmits this disease? The pathogen is trypanosoma and the vector is? Yes, Guru, it is CZ fly. It is CZ flies. Okay, CZ flies, they are considered as a vector that transmits the sleeping sickness. Next is ciliated protozoan. They are aquatic, actively moving organism. Okay, ciliated protozoans are. Presence of thousands of cilia. Presence of thousands of cilia. This is a very important neat question. They have a cavity called gullet. They have a cavity called gullet that opens into outside of the cell surface. The coordinated movement of the rows of cilia with food to be steered into the gullet. For example, paramecium is an example of ciliate. What makes ciliates differ from other protozoan? Ciliates is differing from other protozoan because ciliates have two types of nucleus. 2019 need question. 2019 need MCQ for biology. How do ciliates differ from flagellated protozoan? It is based on the two type of nuclei. Ciliates have two type of nuclei. The last one among the protozoan is the sporozoan. You're welcome, Pranav. This is the most important appreciation that a teacher can get. Thank you so much. Sporozoan. Sporozoans, it includes a diverse organism that has an infectious spore-like stage in their life cycle. The most notorious or the most dangerous is the Plasmodium, studied in the chapter Human Health and Disease. Human Health and Disease, right? About the Plasmodium, sporozoate, signet shaped, all such different spore stages of the Plasmodium vivax, which is referred to as a malarial parasite that causes malaria, a disease which has a staggering effect on human population. Plasmodium is digenetic in nature. Exactly. Plasmodium is digenetic in nature, and digenetic means it requires two hosts. That is, a primary host is the man and the secondary host is female Anopheles mosquito. It is not Aedes mosquito. Aedes mosquito is responsible for elephantiasis. Now it is Anopheles mosquito, female Anopheles mosquito in case of Plasmodium vivax that causes the disease called malaria. Guys, please take down this particular point in your NCRT nearby page number 22. Plasmodium is digenetic in nature. Okay, digenetic means it requires two hosts. Primary host is the man and the secondary host is the female Anopheles mosquito. very important from this chapter, kingdom fungi. Kingdom fungi is a unique kingdom of heterotrophic organism. Unicellular fungi includes yeast, and that is used to make bread and beer. In case of bread industry, it is called baker's yeast. And in case of alcohol industries, they are used as brewer's yeast. What is the scientific name for yeast? Saccharomyces. Saccharomyces is the scientific name for yeast. Wheat rust-causing fungi is Puccinia graminis. Puccinia graminis is the organism or the fungi that causes rust in wheat. Okay. Then there are certain sources of antibiotics in fungi, that is Penicillium notatum. They prefer to grow in warm and humid places. Warm and humid places. In very cold area like freeze, fungi do not grow, and it helps to prevent. From going bad due to bacterial or fungal infection. Their body consists of long, slender, thread-like structures called hyphae. Okay? That is another important question about hyphae. Here, the network of hyphae is known as mycelium. Long, slender-like structures, thread-like structure is called a hyphae. The network of hyphae is called a mycelium. Some hyphae are continuous tube with multinucleated condition. They do not have a septum to differentiate. Suppose this is the hyphae and this is a nucleus. There is no septum to differentiate between the nucleus. Whereas in case of other certain fungi, there are interceptums to differentiate between the fungi. Okay, like this, there are septums to differentiate between the nucleus. So only one nucleus in one particular cell. But in certain case like cenocytic fungi, what happens? The mycelium will be like this, or the hyphae will be like this, and there will be no partition. So one thread-like structure may contain number of nucleus. So they are said to be cenocytic hyphae. The cell walls of fungi are composed of chitin. Chitin is N-acetyl glucosamine and polysaccharide. Very important question. Chitin is found also in another cell wall, exoskeleton of another phylum. Can anybody tell me the type of phylum which you have studied in the animal kingdom? A group of organisms whose exoskeleton is made up of chitin. Vinit, please try to refresh the page if it is buffering. Fast on the chat box. Yes, Guru, it is Arthropoda. Arthropoda has exoskeleton made up of chitin. Next is, most fungi are heterotrophic in nature and can absorb soluble organic matter from dead substrate and hence called saprophytes. So the mode of nutrition in fungi is saprophytic mode of nutrition. They also show symbiotic association. They also show symbiotic association with roots of higher plants such as Pinus. Okay, they show symbiotic association with the roots of higher plants such as Pinus, and it is referred to as mycorrhizae. There are both entomycorrhizae and ectomycorrhizae. Okay, two type of mycorrhizae, endomycorrhizae and ectomycorrhizae. Then you have to study about VAM, which is a vascular arbuscular mycorrhizae. It is an example of endomycorrhizae. Example of endomycorrhizae, vascular arbuscular mycorrhizae, or VAM. Next is reproduction in fungi. Reproduction in fungi takes place by vegetative means, for example, fragmentation, binary fission, or budding. And the asexual reproduction takes place with the help of spores called conidia, sporangiospores, or zoospore. And sexual reproduction takes place by oospore, ascospore, or basidiospore. BOA, basidiospore. The various spores are produced in distinct structures called fruiting bodies. This is an important question. The sexual life cycle involves mainly three major steps. That is in your NCRT, page number 23. Okay, page number 23. Go and read the page number 23 after the class is over today itself. Okay. Fusion of protoplasm between two motile or non-motile gametes is called plasmogamy. Guys, are you all getting me? The chat box is remaining silent. Fusion of protoplasm is called plasmogamy, and fusion of two nuclei is called karyogamy. Then meiosis in zygote resulting in haploid spores. In fungi, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, okay, in the group fungi, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, they have an intervening stage or an intermediate stage called the dikaryotic phase, N plus N stage. Two nuclei per cell, that is a dikaryotic stage. Such a condition known as dikaryon, and that phase is called the dikaryon phase of fungus. You have to study in which all classes of fungi you can see. It is seen in ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. This is a previous year AIIMS question. Okay, previous year AIIMS question about the dikaryon phase of fungus. Later, the parental nuclei fuse and the cells become diploid. The fungi form fruiting bodies in which reduction division occurs, leading to the formation of haploid spores. Clear, everybody? Next is, what forms the basis of fungal classification? It is morphology of the mycelium, mode of spore formation, and the fruiting bodies. This is also can be expected for an MCQ. Okay, morphology of the mycelium, mode of spore formation, and fruiting body. They forms the basis of classification of the fungi. Next, you have four different classes of fungi. First is the phycomycetes. Phycomycetes is an example for the primitive fungus. Okay, members of phycomycetes are found in aquatic habits and on decaying wood, moist and damp places. Very important, moist and damp places. You can see phycomycetes. Or they are act as obligate parasite on plants. What is the condition of the mycelium? The mycelium is aseptate and sinocytic. Study these two conditions. Phycomycetes is the first class of fungi. And in them, you can see the mycelium is aseptate and sinocytic. Asexual reproduction. The vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation, budding, or binary fission. But the asexual reproduction takes place by the help of spore. And in case of motile, they are zoospore. Motile spores that help in asexual reproduction, phygomycetes, it's zoospore. And if it is non-motile spores that help in asexual reproduction, phygomycetes, it is aplanospore. Welcome, Vinit. Thank you for all your comments. Thank you for all your support that you were continuously showing right from the beginning of the session, going good. Okay. Hope you all got at least one extra point that out of NCRT. I hope everybody, at least all the students in the class, might have got at least one extra point that you haven't heard before. Okay. If it is motile, that is called zoospore. And if it is non-motile, it is called aplanospore. These are endogenously produced in a sporangium. They are endogenously produced in a sporangium. Endogenously means they are formed inside. Okay, inside. A zygospore is formed by the fusion of two gametes. A zygospore is formed by the fusion of two gametes. Zygospore is formed by the fusion of two gametes. So here you have to study the mycelium is aseptate and sinocytic. They are found in moist and damp places. Asexual reproduction takes place by zoospore if it is motile, or by aplanospore if it is non-mortal and they are endogenously produced spores. Next one is the ascomycetes, or before that I have to tell the examples of icomycetes. Okay, all of you take a pen and a paper to write down the mnemonics related with the examples of icomycetes. Okay. Take down. So first we are going to write the first mnemonic. Okay. The first mnemonic, it is Ratika. Arrived. Ratika arrived for a movie premiere. For a movie premiere. Okay, got the statement, everybody. Ratika arrived for a movie premiere. That is a mnemonic to remember. So the R in Ratika, it represents rhizopus. Okay, Ratika, the R in Ratika represents rhizopus. A stands for albigo. A stands for albigo. M stands for mucor. M stands for mucor. And the last P of premier stands for phycomycetes. Guys, everybody, can I erase it? Can I erase it? Phycomycetes, examples in your NCERT, rhizopus, albigo, and mucor. You have the mnemonic trick to remember. Ratika arrived for a movie premiere. Ratika arrived for a movie premiere. Rhizopus, albigo, mucor, and phycomycetes. Okay. Next, we are going to study about ascomycetes. Okay, next about ascomycetes. Ascomycetes is commonly known as the sac fungi. Ascomycetes is also known as the sac fungi. They are saprophytic decomposers, parasitic coprophiles, that is growing on the cow dung. Mycelium is branched and is septate. Mycelium is branched and is septate. The asexual spores are exogenously produced in a certain structures called the conidiopores. In case of phycomycetes, you have the asexual spores endogenously produced. And here you have the structures exogenously produced in conidiopores. Conidia on germination produces mycelium. The sexual spores are called ascospore, which are produced endogenously in sac-like asci, that is singular ascus. These asci are arranged in different type of fruiting bodies and are referred to as the ascocarp. Ascospores are found inside the ascocarp. Okay, ascospores are found inside the ascocarp. Guys, one more point in phycomycetes. Phycomycetes is otherwise known as. Phycomycetes is otherwise known as algal fungi. Phycomycetes is otherwise known as algal fungi. And ascomycetes is known as sac fungi. Okay. Clear, everybody? Next is Neurospora. Neurospora is called the Drosophila of plant kingdom. Neurospora is called the Drosophila of plant kingdom. It is used in biochemical and genetic work. Guys, what is the common name for Drosophila? What is the common name for Drosophila, and where do you have studied about this Drosophila? Is it a plant? Fast on the chat. Yes, Divahar, it is fruit fly. Yes, Dima, good. It is, yes, Guru, fruit fly. Okay, Neurospora, that is Drosophila is called a fruit fly. And what was the use, or in which theory was Drosophila melanogaster used? Drosophila melanogaster was used for theory of acquired inheritance by T.H. Morgan and his colleague. So it was used in genetical studies, exactly like that. Neurospora, in case of plants, Neurospora is used as the Drosophila of plant kingdom, or it is used extensively in the biochemical genetic work. Certain members of ascomycetes, such as morels and truffles, they are edible fungus. Delicious. Or they are edible fungus. Examples is aspergillus. Aspergillus, they produce aflatoxin, which are carcinogenic to human. Very important. You have to study this. Drosophila. One question over here. Drosophila of plant kingdom, Neurospora. Edible fungus, morels and truffles. Aflatoxin producing organism, Aspergillus. Claviceps, the most powerful hallucinogen, LSD. Produced by Claviceps purpura. And also causes ergot of rye, also a disease, ergot of rye. Fourth question. So, four important neat questions from one particular slide itself. Claviceps produces a most powerful hallucinogen, that is LSD. And is produced by Claviceps purpura, also causes the ergot of rye. Next, we have the mnemonic to remember the examples of ascomycetes. It is okay. It is crow and parrots. Okay. Crow and parrot are not young. Okay. Crows and parrots are not young. You have each example over here. C stands for claviceps. C stands for claviceps. A stands for aspergillus. A stands for aspergillus. P stands for penicillium. A stands for ascomycetes. A stands for ascomycetes. N stands for Neurospora. And Y stands for yeast. Crow and parrot are not young. Crows and parrots are not young. C stands for claviceps. A stands for aspergillus. P stands for parrot. And A stands for ascomycetes. N for Neurospora and Y for yeast. Clear? Guys, are you understanding? I think our class, we cannot just complete all the four chapters today. Now it will be 12:30. Okay, after this biological classification, we'll stop with the biological classification from plant kingdom and animal kingdom. We'll continue with Mahamarathon on episode 2. Okay. When I schedule the timetable itself, I know that I wouldn't have complete. It would not be possible to complete all the chapters. Anyway, I just try to complete the chapters. Okay. Next is Basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes is called a club fungi. Point number one in Basidiomycetes. Is it okay for everybody, everyone in the class? Give me a heart on the chat box. Okay. Guys, if we conduct the quizzes, those students who are right from the beginning of our channel, they know that we conducted the quiz in Slido and like that. What is your opinion about conducting live quizzes? Will it be useful? Will it be useful? Okay, we'll conduct it. Okay, we'll continue with the mega marathon and everything. So Basidiomycetes, it's called the club fungi, and it is the first point. It is composed of mushroom, bracket fungi, or puffball. Very important. Number second question. Okay, next slide. They grow in soil, on logs and tree stumps, in living plant bodies as parasite. The mycelium is branched and septate. The asexual spores are not found. Okay. The asexual spores are generally not found in case of Basidiomycetes. But vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation, which is the common means of reproduction. The sex organs are absent in Basidiomycetes. But plasmogamy is brought about by the fusion of two vegetative or somatic cells of different strains or genotype. Okay. Study the term for Basidiomycetes and the examples of Basidiomycetes. The resultant structure is a dikaryote. And which give rise to Basidium. Karyogamy and meiosis takes place in the Basidium, producing four Basidiospores are formed. The Basidiospores are exogenously produced on the Basidium. The Basidia are arranged in fruiting bodies called the Basidiocarp. Okay. For example, the examples of Basidiomycetes is Agaricus and Ustilago. Agaricus and Ustilago are examples of Basidiomycetes. Guys, are you getting all the points? The chat box is remaining silent. Are you understanding the portion? Okay. Next, we have Deuteromycetes. Before that, we have to study about the mnemonic to remember Basidiomycetes, that is Abhishek Bachchan, interesting to study, film actor's name. Abhishek Bachchan is from Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh, that is UP. Abhishek Bachchan is from Uttar Pradesh or UP. In here, the A stands for agaricus. Okay. A stands for agaricus. B stands for basidiomycetes. B stands for basidiomycetes. U stands for ustilago. U stands for ustilago. And P stands for Puccinia. Puccinia, ustilago, and agaricus are the examples of basidiomycetes. Guys, clear with the examples, everybody. Next, we are going to study about deuteromycetes. Deuteromycetes is commonly known as the fungi imperfecti. Okay, fungi imperfecti. And in which only the asexual or vegetative phases are known. They are called fungi imperfecti because their sexual phase is unknown or it is incomplete. They reproduce only by asexual spores known as conidia. The mycelium is septate and branched. Some members are saprophytes or parasites where a large number of members are decomposers of litter. This question is a previous year NEET and AIIMS MCQ. Okay, repeated at least 20-25 times repeated question. Okay, name the class of fungi which are composed of decomposers of litters, or which are known as the decomposers of litter and that play an important role in mineral cycling. It is deuteromycetes. For examples are Alternaria, Coleotrichum and Trichoderma. Alternaria, Coleotrichum and Trichoderma. Clear? Next is about the kingdom Plantae, that is from this same chapter, a small portion about the alternation of generation. Before that, you have to study about the mnemonics. Right? So write the mnemonic over there. Deuteromycetes, tawny, loved, daddies, cut at. Okay, Tony loved daddies, cut at. Here, the word Tony or the letter from T, Tony, stands for Trichoderma. D stands for deuteromycetes. C stands for coleotrichum. And A stands for what? Alternaria. Guys, getting everything, guys? Trichoderma, Coleotrichum and Alternaria comes under deuteromycetes. Okay, we have about viruses also in this chapter. Okay. So before that, a small portion about kingdom Plantae. It includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll containing organisms commonly called plants. So in this chapter, you have only a very little portion about plants to study because you have a very detailed chapter. That is a plant kingdom where you will be studying all the detailed explanation regarding the plant kingdom. A few members are partially heterotrophic, such as the insectivorous plants and the parasite. Although every organism bears chlorophyll and they are photosynthetic in nature, some organisms are insectivorous plants and parasites. They are heterotrophic in nature. For example, bladderwort, nepenthes, Venus flytrap are examples of insectivorous plant. The plant cell have a eukaryotic structure, that is, they have a well-defined nucleus. Okay, in the cell of plants, you can see that. Okay, this is the plasma membrane, and now the yellow color represents the cell wall. In case of plant cell, the majority portion of the plant cell is observed or constituted by the structure known as what? Anybody on the chat box? The majority portion of the plant cell wall is made up of a structure. The structure that constitute or that pushes the nucleus to one side of the plant cell. Yes, exactly, the mitis vacuole. Okay, they have prominent structures called the chloroplasts. Guys, are you all others are getting the points? Okay, Calvin, vacuole. Okay, and their cell wall is made up of cellulose. For bacteria, the cell wall was made up of peptidoglycan or murine. For archaebacteria, it was made up of pseudomurine. For fungi, it was made up of chitin. And for plants, it is made up of cellulose. Life cycle of plants has two distinct phases. The diploid sporophytic stage and the haploid gametophytic stage. Okay, diploid saprophytic stage and the haploid gametophytic stage that are alternate to each other. Since they constitute these two phases, they are referred to as the alternation of generation. So that property is referred to as the alternation of generation. Next is Kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia is characterized by the heterotrophic eukaryotic organisms that are multicellular and the cells lack cell wall. Their outer covering of an animal cell, the outer covering is what? Plasma membrane or cell membrane. Guys, tell me an organelle in the animal cell that is only found in this animal cell. Name the cell organelle that is found only in animal cell. Fast on the chat box. Nobody knows the answer. Question from the chapter cell. Cell cycle, cell division. Name the organism that initiates cell division in animal cell. That is the answer. Cell organelle that initiates cell division in animal cell. Centriole, exactly. It forms the astral rays. Remembering, guys, it forms the astral rays during cell division. And in this astral rays where you can find the chromosomes are arranged. Plasma membrane is present both in plant cell and animal cell. Do you remember these kinds of diagram that you drawn in your lab exam? Also, you may have these kinds of diagram. Mitosis, meiosis, anaphase, metaphase. lysosome is present in both the organs, okay? Lysosome is also present in both the organs. Okay. They digest their food in an internal cavity and store food reserves as glycogen or fat globules. Okay. The organism shows a holozoic mode of nutrition, that is by ingestion of food. Ingestion of food, they show a holozoic mode of nutrition. Next is, the sexual reproduction is by the copulation of male and female, followed by the embryonic development. Next is the most important topic from the chapter, that is virus, viroids and lichen. In the five kingdom system of classification that was proposed by Whittaker, there is no mention on the acellular organism. You have to study this. Virus, viroids, all these things are acellular organism. Virus, viroids and lichen, they do not have a cell. They are non-living cells, but when they enter the human body, they try to behave as living things. Okay, these viruses are non-cellular organisms that are characterized by an inert crystalline structure outside the living cell. Only if they infect a cell, they take up the machinery of the host cell to replicate the killing of the host. Name the virus that is found all around you now also. The virus that is spreading at an alarming rate without even giving a chance for the biotechnologists to find a vaccine. Name the virus. Yes, COVID-19. Tremendous COVID-19 spreading all around us. The thing is that they are acellular organisms, right? Suppose the most of you may have a doubt why the scientists, there are certain scientists, biotechnologists, there are laboratories. Then why the vaccination for this coronavirus is getting late? Why can't it be discovered and be treated all the patients at a glance? It is not possible because it is a virus. It is an acellular organism. So once it enters the living organism, it may affect. If suppose it enters a person's body, one person, it may infect the RBC or red blood cells. It may take up the shape of that particular cell and continues its machinery. Okay? That virus will continue to replicate, and before that it will try to regain the shape of that particular cell which is it attacking. Suppose if it enters my body and if it is attacking my red blood cells, and if it is entering some other person's body and it is affecting the liver cells. So in my body, the coronavirus will be having the shape of my red blood cells, and in the other person, it may having the liver cells shape. Okay. As a result, if we are putting in some vaccine for that, it may destruct our own cells. Okay. That is the reason why the discovery of vaccine is getting late. This slide is very, very important. NCERT also, this is mentioned. Complete slide of MCQs. Yes, pleomorphic virus changing time to time. This slide is full of MCQs. Very important. Somebody please take a screenshot before I just write something. You take a screenshot and share it in group now itself. Done, everybody. Okay. The term virus or the name virus was meaning as venom or poisonous fluid. It was given by Pasteur. Okay. It is not D.G. Ivanovsky. Okay. It is a mistake over here. Don't write D.G. Ivanovsky. It is a mistake. The term virus was coined by the term virus meaning venom or poisonous fluid. It was coined by Pasteur, and the term or the organisms named virus was discovered by the scientist D.J. Ivanovsky. Okay, the name virus was given by Pasteur and it was discovered by D.J. Ivanovsky. It is a printing mistake. In addition to the protein, viruses have a genetic material that could be either RNA or DNA. We cannot say that that particular virus has only DNA, because that DNA may be converted into RNA with the help of reverse transcriptase enzyme, molecular basis of inheritance, central dogma. Is it? A virus is a nucleoprotein and the genetic material is infectious. In general, viruses that infect, this is a previous year MCQ, repeated previous year MCQ. Okay, viruses that infect plants have always have a single-stranded RNA. Okay, the viruses that infect plants always have a single-stranded RNA, and the viruses that infect animals have either single or double-stranded RNA or double-stranded DNA. RNA, if present, they may be either be single-stranded or double-stranded, but DNA, it is always double-stranded. Bacterial viruses, the viruses that affect bacteria, or they are known as bacteriophages. So these viruses that infect the bacteria are usually double-stranded DNA viruses. Double-stranded DNA viruses. The protein code called the caspid, is made up of small units called capsomeres that protects the nucleic acid. Guys, those who have your NCRT, please take your NCRT, and on page number 26, you have the diagram 2.6. 2.6, tobacco mosaic virus, TMV, and diagram of a bacteriophage. Have you seen that image of that particular picture of TMV and bacteriophage? So guys, those who are having an NCRT, somebody please take a pic of that particular image of that TMV and bacteriophage and please share it in the group. Mila, is that okay? You please refer the diagram in the group. Some of your friends may share it in the group. Okay. Yeah, it's also in the state board books also. If you have it, it's good. Both are same. In protein coat called the caspid, the protein coat of viruses is called the caspid, and the small subunit you call it as the capsomeres, that is protects the nucleic acid. These capsomeres are arranged in helical or polyhedral geometric form. The viruses cause certain diseases like mumps, smallpox, herpes, measles, polio, swine flu, common cold, yellow fever, influenza, AIDS. AIDS is caused by HIV virus. And finally, COVID-19 by coronavirus. In plants, the symptoms can be mosaic formation, yellowing of leaf, rolling of leaf, vein clearing, dwarfing, and stunted growth. These are some of the symptoms of virus attack in a plant. Clear, everybody? Next is the viroids. Viroids was discovered by T.O. Daner in the year 1971. That was a new infectious agent which was smaller than viruses. All these I am putting in boxes are very, very important. Okay. It caused potato tuber spindle disease and it was found to be a free RNA. It lagged, that is, the viroids lagged a protein cord. The viroids lagged a protein cord that is found in viruses. That is the difference between viroids and viruses. In viruses, a DNA is enclosed in a protein cord. In viroids, no such protein coating is there, and hence the name viroid. The RNA of viroid is a free RNA and it is of low molecular weight. Repeated at least 25 times repeated question. 25 times repeated question. So moving on with the last portion, I think after this we have the next plant kingdom. Okay. Last topic of the chapter, that is lichen. Lichens are the symbiotic association, that is mutually useful association between algae and fungi. The algal component in lichen is called the phycobiont, that is chlorophyceae, and the fungal component is known as mycobion. This algal component, phycobion, belongs to chlorophyceae. Chlorophyceae refers to the green algae. We'll study in the next chapter. And the fungal component, mycobion, refers to the ascomycetes. Exactly, Nila, it is symbiotic association between an algae and a fungi. Symbiotic association between fungi and higher plants is called mycorrhizae, which are autotrophic and heterotrophic respectively. So algal component is autotrophic and fungal component is heterotrophic in nature. Algae prepare food for plants and fungi and provide shelter. Algae provides food for fungi. And what is the function of fungi? Fungi provides shelter. It absorbs the mineral nutrients and water for its partner. Clear, everybody? The first two chapters, important points in the very first episode, Mega Marathon. Was it useful for everybody in the class? Have you enjoyed this lecture? So look, we have plant kingdom, and at last we have animal kingdom. Anandam is a very lengthy chapter. We have a little more portions to study in the animal kingdom. Thanking you all those who have cooperated in the session. Hope you have got at least something important from spending the last your precious 2 hours with Team BioPoint. Okay, I'm going to end the live. Take care, everybody. See you with the next live. Do you want me to continue this Maha Marathon episodes in the upcoming classes? How many of you need this Maha Marathon episodes in the upcoming classes also? Or else I have to give you detailed explanation of each and every chapter. Okay, in next class, see you with Plant Kingdom, Animal Kingdom. Okay, so stay tuned with our Telegram group. Hope you all are in the Telegram group, and stay tuned with BioPoint. Hit the like button before you end the session. Hit the like button now itself and give the support. You can show your love and support to us in the form of okay, so I am ending the Maha Marathon number 1 episode on biological classification and living world. Okay, take care, everybody. Bye bye. See you in the next live. If you have any doubt regarding the session, stay updated with the Telegram group and comment your doubt in the group. I'll be there for you to clear the doubts. So thank you, everybody, for your wonderful cooperation for the last 2 hours. Thank you, everyone. Bye. Take care.